Now here's something fun you can play around with and it may be useful. Say you want to send somebody a message over iMessage using a calendar alert. So in other words, you're pre-scheduling a message to send them. You can do this with Automator. It's not foolproof, so you may want to experiment with it. I'm doing this in Sierra, and of course it assumes that you've got lots of things in place and working. But we'll give it a try. So in Automator here we're going to create a new script and we're going to make it a calendar alarm so we can insert it in the calendar when we're done. Then there's no send message library command in Automator. We're going to use an Apple script to do it. So we're going to drag run Apple script action over here. It gives us this nice blank Apple script that we can fill in. So now we have to fill in the parts of the code. There's only three lines that we need. Actually more like five, because the first thing we need to do is we need to tell the Messages app to do something. And we'll end the tell. And then the three lines that we need to tell the Messages app, first is to get the service. So Messages is capable of using various services, iMessage, SMS, all sorts of things. So we want to go and set it up so that it's actually going to send via iMessage. So this is setting a variable we call iMessage service to the first service whose service type equals iMessage. That's just the wording of it, or the awkwardness of Apple scripts. The next thing we want to do, and I'm just copying and pasting here rather than typing it fresh to make it quicker, is we want to get the person we're sending it to. Now these are still called buddies, which is a holdover from the old iChat app. So the iMessage buddy is our variable to buddy, and then here's the email address of the buddy that we're going to send it to. This is an email address of somebody that has iMessage of iMessage service. So now we're all set and ready to send, and we just need to issue the command, which is just a send command. Send, and then the text we want to send. We could have used one of these parameters here to actually input the text. Matter of fact, we could have used this parameter for the email address, their Apple ID, and this parameter for, say, the text. But we're just keeping things simple here. If you know more Apple script, you can further customize this. And we're just going to send it. And this will work. It will actually send this out. And you can actually see this in your Messages app. So let's bring up the Messages app here. And you can see I have a conversation already going with this demo iCloud account I have set up. So when I run this Apple script, you'll actually see it, the message go out. And you can see it went out just as if I had typed it. And on the other end, you would get the message coming in just as if the person had typed it. So this is an Apple script and I can now save this and use it as a calendar alarm. So let's save. I'll call it send test message. And it sets it up here in calendar, launches calendar, puts it right there. Now I can double click on it and I can edit it. So I can set it to another time. So I can set it to say the 28th, 9:41. The alert is going to be open file at time of event and it's going to open that Apple script and run it and automatically send that. Of course my Mac needs to be running needs to be able to trigger this event which will then launch Messages and send the message. But it does it without me actually having to be there as long as I haven't shut my Mac off. So this will then get sent across. So a couple of things. In my tests I couldn't get this to work if I'd never sent a message to that Apple ID before. But as long as I had an open conversation going already, which most of us do with people that we message regularly, it worked fine. And it even worked when I deleted that conversation. So I had a previous conversation, I deleted it, but the Messages app still recognized this command. But if I tried to send it to an account that I never had communicated with before from this Apple ID, it didn't work. So you may want to keep that in mind. The other thing is, of course, this only works with iMessage, Apple system. So what if you want to send to somebody that's not on iMessage? They have a traditional SMS system like they're on Android or something. Well, you can do that. The command is actually only a one line command you need. And it's basically send the message and it's to buddy and then the phone number of service SMS. Now of course this only works if you've already connected your iPhone and your Mac so that you can send SMS messages. Because remember, you can't send SMS messages from your Mac because it's not a mobile device. It's not hooked up to a network like AT&T, Sprint, Verizon, or T-Mobile. So only your phone could do that. But Messages has the ability, your phone actually has the ability to forward and receive messages from your Mac and then send them on to an SMS network. If you're already using that functionality, as many of us are, then using this will work just fine to go send through messages to your iPhone invisibly. You don't have to worry about it. And you'll actually be able to send these off to people with SMS text messaging as opposed to iMessage. So play around with this and see what if it works for you. It's not going to work for everybody. There's lots of different moving parts here. But it's useful if you can get it to work. If you know a little Apple script and can customize this to fit your needs, it could be a great tool in your toolbox.